President Obama is the least transparent president in the history of this country. If Barack Obama opens up and gives his college records and applications, and if he gives his passport applications and records, I will give to a charity of his choice anything he wants, a check immediately for $5 million.
Is that it? As Peggy Lee of Donald Trump's generation once asked, is that all there is? Donald Trump's big revelation about Barack Obama was not a revelation at all, just an offer, one that will probably never be met. Now, I know Trump has a reputation for hyperbole by, you know, exaggeration. He's a great showman, obviously. But sometimes for highly dubious claims about Obama, if not outright lies, I have to admit, I was somewhat interested in what the Donald would have to reveal about Obama just a couple of weeks before the vote. The big man tells the internet he has a major announcement about Obama. And it ends up being about Trump and his money. Not exactly blowing the lid off. How did the internet feel about how inconsequential the big man's announcement was? Will this be the last time they listen to the Trumpster? I wouldn't hold my breath. He does know how to tease. For much more, we turn to Sun News social media correspondent Gina Phillips. Gina, what was the reaction to Donald Trump's nothing?
The reaction was so funny. Trump got trumped pretty much because it got thrown back in his face. He became the joke online because people were literally going, seriously, that's all you had to say? That was the major announcement. Unbelievable. And the jokes just started. And pretty soon his name was trending. And it was all insulting and making fun of Donald Trump.
I don't want to get into a whole lot of psychology about Donald Trump and how lonely the guy must be in real life to need this kind of attention. But putting that aside, do you think this affects his brand in any way, or do you think the next time, 6 months from now, a year from now, he does a similar tease that people will still tune in and see what the Donald has to say when he comes down from Mount Sinai?
I think so. You know, he's such a character, and everybody knows him as just being so full of himself. I call him a drama queen all the time. So people, regardless of how kind of disappointed or rolling their eyes they were at this announcement, it was still a major impact thing that happened. I mean, people were still talking about it. I mean, yeah, he was the butt of his own joke, but people are still talking about him. I mean, he did still get a ton of headlines and that sort of thing. So I think that maybe it'll make people not take him as seriously, I guess, but who are these people that were really taking him so seriously in the first place? I mean, everybody kind of considers him to be, a great businessman. He knows his brand, all of those things, but the guy is a bit over the top, and people are used to that.
Well, you know, I mean, for the longest time, he had millions, not just, he had millions of people thinking that he was running for president. And then he sat in his, you know, Trump Tower suite asking for certain people to come visit with him. Some of them chose to visit with him, you know, candidates for the presidency, some not. He decided to pontificate about the wisdom of those who chose not to visit with him, who chose to reject a meeting with His Eminence. And sometimes I ask myself, is all of this just shtick? Is he just acting, or has he got a problem?
I don't know. I mean, certainly he's an egomaniac. Is he a little bit delusional? Yeah, I think so. I mean, I think truly in his own world, he really thought that this would be a huge, huge announcement and that this could really change the way that people look at Barack Obama and this could really, you know, become transparent like everybody wants. I think that he truly, honestly believed in this and that it was a big deal, which is hilarious. Like, oh my gosh, this guy, I think he's just totally ridiculous personally.
But I mean, if this is an effort to truly hurt Obama,
Right.
It misfires. All it does is help him. I mean, Obama goes on Jay Leno, and Leno says, you know, what's with you and Trump? And Obama says, well, you know, we both grew up in Kenya. We played soccer. He wasn't as good as I was. And, you know, and everybody's laughing, and they're laughing at the Donald.
Absolutely. And, you know, Donald Trump has just tried to keep his foot in this presidential race the entire way through. I mean, like you said, he held meetings in his office and all that. But also, he's been live tweeting every single debate. So many tweets. Like, I don't even know how this guy keeps up with it all. But no, he's been live tweeting everything. He comments on everything. And every time he comments, it's like he's making some groundbreaking statement. Or I think he believes that that's what's happening here. So he's really tried to stay involved in the entire process. And this was just, I think, another way for him to get in there and be part of it. It's like he's left out or something. I don't know.
And he continues to win in the sense of getting more and more attention. I mean, he was on Letterman last night.
Yep, exactly. He's still in the headlines. And I think this guy's just going to be famous for forever for just making a lot of noise.
And Stephen Colbert was all over the Trump thing, yes. And I can't repeat on a family show what Colbert said. If people want to go to Twitter, want to Google that, they can find out what Colbert said, the offer that Colbert made to Donald Trump. Let's move on to something that's a lot more serious, and this is the cover-up on Benghazi. What kind of action is this getting in social media?
Oh, yeah. I mean, it got a ton of reaction. People certainly... You know, even pro-Obama, the Obama supporters were looking at this and feeling lied to, feeling like they were kind of backstabbed in a sense. Now, on the other side of it, some people were going, well, he is the president and the White House does have to keep some secrecy. But still, I mean, people want to know, and people found it ridiculous in the first place that they blamed it all on this video. And the fact that he knew that it was a terrorist attack in the first place, I think people, it's a little scary. You know, it's a lot of secrets. It's a lot of lying to the public, and people hated that.
One of the people who died, a Navy SEAL, and his dad is now telling reporters that at the funeral, and Hillary Clinton was at the funeral for his son, that at the funeral, Hillary Clinton tried to reassure him that she would find, that they would find the person responsible and arrest him. And she was talking about the person who made the videotape. Now, I don't know for a fact that that's, you know, there's no audio tape or videotape of Hillary Clinton saying that. But the truth is that she was part of that, and that she's got a sterling reputation in many parts of the world. But I don't know why she is doing this to herself. What's social media saying about Hillary Clinton beating up on her own brand by having participated in this nonsensical cover-up?
You know what? I think you're right in that people do respect Hillary Clinton. I think that there's still that sense of respect. And yes, if anything, it's just her association with Barack Obama that people are kind of shaking their heads at. You know, I suspect this story is kind of new about this SEAL and the funeral. But as this continues, I think that she should almost pull back. I think she needs to start separating herself, because it's true, she has that great reputation. People on social media aren't bashing her like they're bashing Barack Obama. And it's kind of a chance that she's taking, certainly, and people are seeing that.
The other day, when everyone found out about emails that Hillary Clinton's State Department got, the White House got within 2 hours, emails telling them that this was a terror attack, and she was confronted by the business of the emails, and she chortled and told people that you know, there's lots of information that comes in after an attack, but she wanted not to take it seriously, and it was a fake chortle. It was phony, and 4 people are dead. Don't know why she wants to play it this way. But thank you so much for coming in and giving us the light and the serious on social media.
No problem.
Phillips, appreciate your time every Friday.
Thanks, Charles.
Gina Phillips is our social media specialist at the Sun News Network. Don't forget to tune into our Chorus Radio show, markets across this country, Pacific to Atlantic, in Toronto, Talk Radio AM 640, in Winnipeg, CGOB 68, 630 Chet in Edmonton, QR in Calgary, the Ralco team in Regina and Saskatoon. Share your opinions with me on Monday. Call us 800-665-2202.